The use of prescribed fire can enhance timber growth, and forests managed with prescribed fire are less prone to destructive wildfire.
All right, guys. Appreciate you coming out for the burn today. Here's a map for everyone. We'll
go over this. So how is prescribed fire done? It's a team effort. They gather to come up with a plan. They determine things like size, location, acceptable weather parameters, and what the outcome should be.
The unit we're burning is called the Sloan unit. It is a 2-year rough. It's been 2 years since we burned it. We're gonna burn inside of the fire breaks. We've got a fire break on 3 sides. This is a dirt road, and that will be our 4th fire break on our unit. You know, the people that are doing the prescribed burns are professionals. They know what to do. They know how to do it. They know how to see how the fire's behaving. They know how to modify their techniques to keep things under control and to get the desired results that you're looking for out of that burn. We're gonna break into 2 groups. We're gonna have an ignition crew, which will be Caroline and Kevin. We're gonna have a holding crew, Jerome, Ron, and Jason. So let's get our tools and get our stuff and let's head out to the unit.
When we go to actually implement a controlled burn, we have a plan. We follow that plan. That plan has parameters for weather conditions, smoke direction, relative humidity. We always ignite a test fire, which is a small fire, to see if the fire indeed is doing what we expect it to do, if it's controllable, if it's going to meet our objectives. And then during the actual burn, we continue to monitor the weather. We often have observers out on the highways checking if we're doing any sort of visibility reduction. We'll have people checking the humidity to be sure we're still in prescription. And we'll be monitoring the fire behavior itself to make sure that it's within the parameters that we would like it to be to achieve the goals we've set out for that.
And amazingly, within a short time, the black begins turning green again.
In most plants in these fire-dependent habitats, resprout very quickly after they burn. So it's kind of like mowing the grass. When you cut the grass, you're not killing the grass. You're just knocking it back to the ground. And that's what fire mostly does in these habitats.